Hey guys, Pippin, it's Gamer, and I'm back with another video, and today we're going to be talking about iOS 13. So, this was just announced a few days ago, and I wanted to kind of give it a couple days to kind of just sit, let me kind of read all about it, and then talk about it. Now, I haven't done a video like this in a while where I kind of just talk about a certain, you know, just top five features or something like that. I usually don't do that, but for this one, I thought it would be just a good thing to note because there are some interesting things in here, both good and bad for just iOS gaming in general. So let's go ahead and get into the top five features and then we'll talk about some of the bad stuff. So, number one, dark mode. I, for one, love dark mode. It just makes all your kind of UI dark. It could even say battery. Seeing as some of the Apple devices are OLED, you know, displays, you can sometimes get true black where the pixels actually turn off instead of kind of just like dim. So you will be saving some battery there, which is good. Aside from that, I mean, every single app that they have, stock app as well as they put it in the SDK, so any developers can put sort of dark mode in their specific apps. Some apps already do have that kind of thing. Like Twitter, for instance, has some sort of dark mode. Discord, of course. Light mode on Discord is terrible. But yeah, overall, just a great feature to have, and they finally brought it, so you don't need to jailbreak for that specific thing anymore. Number two is sign in with Apple. So, it's been a very apparent for me. There are lots of apps on the App Store where when you download it, and it requires you to sign in. And so some apps, even games, like say sign in with Facebook or sign in with Google or something. And since Apple's kind of pushed away kind of from Game Center, I usually use Game Center to sign in to things and usually does it automatically. But there are times where it's like sign in with Facebook or sign in with Google and it's just very annoying. It's a hassle. I personally don't even use Facebook anymore just for, I don't know, I can't delete it, honestly. I really cannot delete Facebook. I can deactivate it, but I can't delete it. But anyways, so with sign in with Apple, basically you'll be able to sign in with your Apple ID, and all you have to do is just tap it, it'll do a Face ID thing, done. And that way, so if they're trying to get your information, like your email, for instance, or your name, Apple will create a sort of spoof email for you. So any emails that company that you opened their app for and you signed up for, with your Apple ID, if they try to email you, it'll go to that spoof email, so technically you'll never see that email or any future emails from these companies. So basically, huge privacy thing, and that's what I really like about Apple is the privacy. So that's a good thing to have, especially in future games. So basically what they intended now is they put in the guidelines that if a game or app has a sign in with Facebook or sign in with Google or some sort of thing like that sign in feature, they have to put sign in with Apple. So it's against the terms of service, against the guidelines if they don't do that. So that is a good thing to have. This one is a bit of a small thing, but interesting kind of thing is to share audio. So if you have two pairs of AirPods, like you have an AirPod and your friend has AirPods, you can kind of just share audio. So it can be game audio, movie audio, like whatever it may be, you can just share audio with that. So it's really, really cool that you can do that. And you can control the audios from, you know, your phone. So that's a very nice thing to have, a little small feature, but it's welcome, even though I don't have AirPods, but it's still good to have. So 4 and 5 kind of go together. But basically apps now launch twice as fast. And Apple has done a few things. So they optimized it a bit, as well as they reduced the animation when you're opening an app and closing an app. So it definitely just is overall in general faster, which is good. The other thing is that app downloads and updates are 50 to 60% smaller. So Apple has now a different way how they package the apps on the App Store. So when you download, you know, an app, it will be, I believe, 50 to 60% smaller, and then updates are also smaller. So won't be taking much screen, storage space, and overall just better for your device in general. Now let's talk about the bad. So those are my top five features you just saw. Overall, pretty good, you know, nothing too huge, you know, of anything. The bad, two things. So number one, iPadOS. So iPadOS is essentially iOS 13 for the iPad. Apple is kind of splitting it away from the kind of bigger iPhone, you know, thing that everyone's saying that iPad has been, which in some cases it really is. But iPadOS, they're trying to move away from that. And honestly, it was just really underwhelming for me. I think iPadOS is just for people that just like want to use the iPad as a computer. And the fact is that like the files app is now more in tune with like a computer, so it's more detailed and everything, and you can download stuff on Safari now and put it on there. iPadOS lets you multitask more, so the multi-window support, and that's basically it. Literally, that's it. I mean, yeah, you get the more icons on your screen and then like the widgets on the screen as well, but like honestly, that's really it. It's literally that, and then whatever iOS 13 has as well with dark mode and all that stuff. But it's honestly very underwhelming for me. I mean, I honestly didn't know what to expect, but there you have it. But there is something that came with that that is very frustrating. So there is now controller and mouse support, or I guess a more enhanced controller support as well as mouse support now. So control support, as in PlayStation 4 and Xbox One controllers, are now able to use on the iPad or iPhone. All you gotta do is just connect it, and it'll work on any game you launch that supports controllers. So that's not too bad. There are people that hate people that use controllers. It's like, I don't know, it's just a thing in the community. I personally will say, as I've always said, controllers are not that big of a deal for me, because I personally think that touch controls are the way to go. Like, the game is meant for touch controls. Like, if you don't get good with that, I mean, if you're more comfortable with controller, that's fine. But for me, I've always told people, practice using the touch controls. Try not to use a controller. It may feel nice with the physical buttons, but the point is to use the touch controls and really get used to it. And as you guys have seen in my videos, you can be good without a controller. I don't use a controller in any gameplay or any game that I play on my iPad. So there's that. Now, the other thing is mouse support. And this is frustrating. Now, this isn't kind of a kind of feature that can be done like a controller. You have to physically go to your accessibility settings, and those are kind of like the hidden things settings, and that's where you can do like invert colors or assistive touch. So when you activate assistive touch, you can activate the mouse feature, and you can either do wired or wireless mouse and plug it in, and then it acts as this kind of black circle which you can move around with the mouse, and it looks like it works really well. Now, my main concern about this is that since it is in iOS 13, it's a little frustrating, because I'm not sure, honestly, 100%, if game developers are able to access this feature. It's in the accessibility, so I don't know. But if game developers are allowed to get access to that, and they allow mobile users to use, like, mice, that very much annoys me, because obviously a mouse, you're going to get more accuracy out of it, and it's just a lot better to use than touch controls, in my opinion. Like, definitely playing a first person shooter, like, you've seen how I play. Like, I can play pretty well, but a mouse is obviously, you're gonna get the finer kind of adjustments, you know, since you're using, you know, the whole hand instead of like fingers. So I don't know how I feel about that. If it's put into games, that's going to annoy the living hell out of me. But you know, and just to talk about the uprise that's going to go in the community, everyone's going to go crazy for it. They're going to be like, oh, you mouse user, blah, blah, blah. Like, I know how it's going to go. I've been in this community for, like, almost 10 years now. Like, I know how it's going to go. So, I hope that's not the case. A controller, again, doesn't bother me so much. COD Mobile just finished its beta in India, and there's going to be another beta in Australia soon. So, we'll see what happens then, if people will try it out. You know, with control support, I'm not sure if they'll allow mouse support off the bat, or if they even will do it in the first place. No idea. But anyways, guys, that's sort of my iOS 13 video, just encompassing the update, what I think about it. Top 5 features, it's not bad. It's just, I feel like it's okay. It's necessary for right now. But hopefully iOS 14 is just like a major overhaul. iPadOS was a bit underwhelming, not gonna lie. And other than that, I mean, that's pretty much, I mean, there's probably like hundreds of other features as well that'll show up every now and then, but those are kind of the main ones that I've kind of pointed out. But anyways, guys, let me know what you guys think down in the comments about iOS 13 and iPadOS, and as well as the mouse support. I'm really interested to see what you guys think about that. Because for me, I've been in this community a long time. I played, you know, the first FPS game ever, you know, on iOS. Like the first mainstream one. I've played every Modern Combat. I've played Fortnite. I've played all these games. And it's just frustrating because, like, the point of mobile gaming for me, the reason I got into YouTube was to show, I mean, obviously from other YouTubers, but mostly to show people that mobile gaming can actually be a competitive thing, not just bots and, you know, people kind of cheating their way around it, you know? So the fact is that when I mention mobile gaming to someone, I want it to be to a day where it's like, dude, that's awesome. Instead, when people ask me, what do you do? And I say mobile gaming, they're just like, oh, like, you know, that's, you know, what do you play, like these phone games? Like, people still don't understand and what people can do on mobile. If they actually see, I mean, I know people get like surprised that like they see Fortnite mobile gameplay of mobile gamers. They're like, whoa, how does he do this? Like, I'm just here just like, just, you know, I know they're not in the mobile community, but come on, just give a little respect for mobile gamers. Now that COD Mobile's coming out, there are just games. I mean, I saw that there was still auto fire in the game, and then there's like this new MMO that came out, World of Kings, that literally plays the game for you, literally auto attacks, auto does everything. It's so frustrating. It's so frustrating for me. But anyways, I kind of went on a bit of a rant there. But anyways, if you guys like these sort of videos, definitely let me know. I'll definitely do more of them. I got some more gameplays down the line in the future, so just stay tuned. And without further ado, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you guys in the next one.